Mike, a down-to-earth construction worker, is thrust into the world of super spies and secret agents when his high school sweetheart, Roxanne, recruits him on a high-stakes U.S. intelligence mission. When I first heard about The Union, the 2024 American spy action comedy thriller directed by Julian Farrino, I was intrigued. The idea of seeing Mark Wahlberg and Halle Berry, two competent actors with solid action pedigrees, sharing the screen, along with the always impressive J.K. Simmons, seemed like a recipe for success. With such a strong cast, I expected the film to deliver something memorable, even if it leaned into the typical Netflix formula of high-profile stars in mediocre films. Unfortunately, my expectations were only partially met. Halle Berry, in particular, shines in this film. Her action sequences are a thrill to watch, and she dominates the screen in every scene she's in. Berry's portrayal of Roxanne, a seasoned and resourceful spy, gives the film its most exciting moments. Her charisma and presence elevate the otherwise lackluster material, and without her, The Union would be much less engaging. Mark Wahlberg, on the other hand, is a mixed bag. As the male lead, Mike, his character is unfortunately underdeveloped. Wahlberg has the potential to be a great action star, but in this film, he's given little to work with. Mike has no real emotional arc, and his role in the story feels more reactive than proactive. He's a character who seems to be pushed around by the plot rather than driving it forward. His motivation to stay involved in the spy world after his first mission failed is weak, and his character comes off as forgettable, a significant flaw in a film where the leads should be compelling. The action scenes, while entertaining, can't save the film from its deeper issues. The script is predictable and lacks depth, and the pacing is rushed. There's an attempt to build tension and emotional stakes, particularly through the on-and-off relationship between Mike and Roxanne, but these moments are quickly brushed aside in favor of the next action set piece. As a result, the film feels disjointed and the emotional weight of key scenes never really lands. J.K. Simmons, who plays the boss of the organization, is another wasted opportunity. Simmons is an actor who can command attention with just a few lines, but in The Union, he's relegated to the background, providing exposition and little else. His character lacks the authority and gravitas that such a role demands, and it's hard to take him seriously when he seems so indifferent to everything happening around him. The film misses out on developing his character into something more than just a plot device. The film's climax, with the reveal of the main antagonist, is so predictable that it undercuts any potential suspense. When Roxanne's ex-husband shows up to reveal that Simmons' character is the mole, it's clear from the start who the real culprit is. The film doesn't give the audience time to absorb the impact of this revelation, instead rushing toward the next action scene. This pacing issue is a recurring problem, as the movie seems more interested in keeping the adrenaline pumping than in developing its characters or story. Despite these flaws, I can't say that The Union was a total disappointment. Watching Wahlberg and Berry together was fun, and there's a certain charm to the film's straightforward approach to the spy genre. However, the negatives outweigh the positives, and the film doesn't have the rewatch value or memorable scenes that would make me want to revisit it. In conclusion, The Union is a one-time watch. It's the kind of film you might enjoy if you're in the mood for something light and unchallenging, or if you're a fan of the lead actors and want to see them in action. But beyond that, there's little to recommend. The film is fine for if casual viewing or as background entertainment, but it ultimately lacks the substance to make it truly stand out in a crowded genre. That's my opinion on The Union. Do you agree with my thoughts? What are your thoughts on the film? Let me know in the comments. Please drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. What did happen to the last 10? I ran away with my life, fast forward, never turn back again. It's kind of funny that the more we pass time, the more we need to set them rewind. And 19 was the year I had to leave you, but now I'm seeing all the signs. Is this